Hello and welcome to Ikebana Beautiful. Today I show you a couple of my containers. I sorted them out in black and in more brownish orange color, because that's beautiful together. I start with this moon container. I made an arrangement in it a couple of weeks ago, and you can have a look at it here if you click here in the corner. I use this big moon container for it, and several people asked me what kind of material is it. It is wood, and where did you buy them? I did buy them at the Sugetsu Ikebana branch in the Netherlands. A Dutch couple made them specially for the branch. And I don't know if they still make them, so I'm sorry to have not more information about these containers. I have three of them, in a mid size and also in a small size, and you can use them together. You can use them in three, so you make an arrangement with that three containers, or just two or one, you can choose. And what you can do with the container, you can put a Kanzan inside and you can make it by stabilize it in another way, give it a little other shape. And I do it like this, you can see it then. This is where I have the Kanzan here, and if I place it in another part of the container, you have another shape and form, and you can choose where you put the Kanzan in. And you can also hang them, if you hang them here on a spike or just on rope. You can hang them also. So I think this is a very beautiful, typical Japanese container. And I like it because they are black. From my mother, I got this beautiful triangle containers. I have them in beige, brownish color, and in black. And what you can do is make an arrangement just in one of the containers. But what you can do also, oops, I wanted to show you like this. You can stable them and you can have an arrangement here or here or here, and you can choose and make it more more volume. You make more volume of your containers, and you're playful with the containers when you stable them. But you can also make a shape like this. You can choose, and I think it's very nice to have a couple of the same containers, so you can play with them around. And this is another one, a black one. I bought it from the same Dutch couple. You can place it on a table like this, but you can hang it here on a spike, and you can make a wall arrangement in it. What I think is a little bit difficult to arrange in this container when you put it on the table is that it has a big black space and a small hole, and that is not so easy to make a beautiful arrangement, because you haven't so much space. If you use it as a hanging arrangement, it's easier because you let branches come down, and it is even more easy to arrange in it. But if you use it on the table, more difficult. Then this is a Mobach container I got from my mom. It's a very beautiful one, I think, because it has a shape like this. When you put it on the table, it's still elegant because it has a curve up. And what is special about this container, the height of the container. It's not so high, and therefore it's very beautiful to show the water inside the container. If you put a candle in and you have an arrangement, then you can still enjoy the water around, and that's very quieting and very beautiful if you use that that water around. So I think this container is very useful when you use a lot of water in it. And this container, for example, this is also a container from Mobach. That's a Dutch maker, Dutch fabric. And here you see that it's a quite heavy container. It's quite a big container. So in this container I use always big branches, and the height of the container makes it a little bit more difficult to have branches in it. And I show you what I mean. When you have your Kanzan inside and you like to bend or have a low branch in the arrangement, then you see that it's more difficult because you have a high end of the container. If you put a Kanzan in this container, then you can see that your branches can be more can be lower because of the height of the container. It isn't so high, and you can therefore use better your branches. And you see it here in this container, the height is in the middle of this and this container. It has the possibility to use your branches still low, but you see here that you have to look at where you put your Kanzan in the container. And here you see you can still put your Kanzan near the rim of the container, and you still can have your branches very low. So that's the difference between a high container and a low container. This container is also very playful, because you can have your Kanzan here with your arrangement, for example, and then you can have here water, or you can use two Kanzans, for example, a small part of the arrangement here and another part of the arrangement there, and you still have connection while you have one container you use, one shape of a container you use, and you can use both parts of that shape. And I think this color is also playful. It's orange, and you can use orange flowers with it, but it's also very beautiful with yellow flowers, or really bright green branch leaves. So this is another, it's also a wooden container. And what I have here as the last container for this video, this is a typical container for an arrangement in a row. I made such an arrangement in it. I think I made an arrangement with yellow in it. I put a video here, link here. You can see what I made of it. And what you can do here is put your Kanzans in And what I use for this kind of containers is a bar. Oop. It's a bar kanzan. So you have a rectangle kanzan and you put it then inside so you can put your branches in here. So yes, these are a couple of my containers. I don't think I made an arrangement already for a video in this one, so definitely gonna make a video with them in one of the next videos. And I hope you enjoyed it. If you have questions or suggestions for videos, please give me a comment. If you like the video, give a thumb up for me. It's my energy, my boost to create more videos for you. I wish you a very happy weekend and happy week. And thanks for watching. Bye bye.